Hello everyone. So in this session, we're going to start the configuration of Material Master. Now Material Master, whenever we create a material, after entering the material type and industry sector, we get to see the list of views which can be, out of which the relevant views can be selected. So the first configuration that we're going to talk about is how to maintain that combination of views, and in each view, how to specify the combination of subscreens. So this element subscreen sequence is used for maintaining the combination of views and subscreens for each criteria, for each combination of criteria. These criteria are username, that is the SAP username, the transaction code, material type, and industry sector. They can use any one or a combination of these criteria for creating and assigning the screen sequence. So basically, username will be used when the client requires a specific set of views only to be available for specific users. For instance, people in the sales department need to access only the basic data and the sales data and not any other type of data. Similarly, purchasing department employees may be restricted to only basic data and purchasing data. So we use the username combination, username criteria to create the screen sequence containing only those combinations of views and subscreens, and when we assign it to that user, then when that user logs in, he will be restricted to only those views, right? So like this, based on any of these criteria, we can create a screen sequence and assign it so that when that specific criteria or the condition is met, the relevant combination of views and subscreens are available for use. Now, since the screen sequence should contain only those views and subscreens, the standard SAP system comes with certain predefined views, predefined screen sequences, which can be used for creating a new screen sequence. So the standard screen sequence, which contains all the views and subscreens as defined by SAP, is 21. Now, each screen sequence is identified by a 2-character alphanumeric code, whereas the criteria are identified with a 1-to-4-character code called screen reference. Okay? So we use the standard screen sequence 21, copy it to create a new screen sequence, which will contain all the views and subscreens as required for that criteria. Create a code for that criteria called screen reference, and use the combination of screen references to assign that screen sequence so that when that condition is met, the relevant screen sequence gets triggered. So let's see how to create and assign a new screen sequence. Let me log into the server. One moment. Since all the configuration activities happen in the IMG screen, so we go to SPRO IMG. Now we go to Logistics General, Material Master, configuring the Material Master. First step would be to define the screen sequence. So we use the option Define Structure of Data Screens for each screen sequence. Click on Execute. And you'll see a list of all the screen sequences already maintained in this system. Just taking a little bit more time than expected. Just need to wait. So once it displays the list of all the screen sequences, select the standard screen sequence, which is 21. Click on copy as and enter a new code starting with the letter Y or Z. And it has to start with Y or Z. And the description here for practice, I'm just entering screen sequence 1, but in the real time, please ensure that you clearly identify for what purpose you are creating this green sequence. So if you're creating it for the combination of raw material and mechanical engineering industry sector, give the description as such, ROH in mechanical engineering industry sector. So that later on, once you start working, once you start doing other things, you may forget what you have, why you have created that screen sequence. So this description will clearly specify for what reason you have created it, right? Now, the reason why it should start with Y or Z is because there are a lot of, there are a few predefined screen sequences. So to differentiate user-specific screen sequence from the predefined list, we use the letter Y or Z. So any screen sequence starting with the letter Y or Z, the consultants will understand that it is created as per the client requirement and normally will not be changing that. So once it is copied, once you get the copy confirmation, select that screen sequence, double click on data screens, and it will show me the list of all the views which are available for selection. You get to see a total of 68 views. Now each of these views is identified by a screen number. This is the screen sequence, screen number, the description, screen control, which manages how the display will look, the maintenance status, indicating what type of data is maintained in that view, GUI status, the kind of interaction, the graphical user interface screen, and the alternate description. Now, the system will be able to, the application will be able to identify whether it's a main data screen or additional data screen by using this maintenance status column. If you see only one or two entries here, then the screen is a main data screen. However, if you see a lot of entries like this, then that view is an additional data screen, because the values in the additional data screen should be common for all the views. That is why the maintenance status column will have almost all the view list. Okay, so if you don't want, obviously we don't want to maintain all the 68, so select those views that we don't want and delete them. So the way to delete it is just selecting the views that you have, that you're going to keep, and deselecting those that you want to maintain. Okay, you can also select the additional data screens here. So all those views that I have deselected, they are the ones that I'm going to keep. All those that are selected, I'm going to delete. And make sure that you are making the changes in the screen sequence that you have created. Do not make any changes to the standard screen sequence 21, either in practice or in the real time. Okay, so once it makes the changes, you get the message, number of dependent entries deleted. It means it's done. So now I'm left with only 18 views. Okay. Select a view, double click on subscreens to see the list of subscreens. Click on view data screen and it will display the complete screen as designed by SAP. So here I have material description, general data, material authorization, dimensions, competitor, packaging, and basic data text, which are a total of 7 subscreens. But if I look at the list, I see there are a total of 10 subscreens. So this is the screen sequence, screen number, that is the data screen number, the order number in which the subscreens are going to appear, and the screen number of the subscreen. So when I look at this, at the bottom I have 3 subscreens with the same number. When I select a subscreen and click on view subscreen, it shows me just a blank screen. Almost every view will have at least one blank screen, so that in case any additional data has to be displayed in the view, I can use that blank screen to add that field in an additional subscreen. Okay, so like I said, almost every view will have at least one subscreen. Now, if I don't want all the subscreens, in fact, during practice, I'm only entering material description, general data, and dimensions. So, since I'm not using the other subscreens, I can as well delete them. So, select the first subscreen, view subscreen, it will show me what it is. Deselect, go to next one. This also I require. Deselect, go to next one. If you don't want this subscreen, all you need to do is just delete it. So like this, when I delete, it will automatically remove that subscreen. So select the next one, click on view subscreen, you don't want that, delete it.